students, welcome to Sri Guru Bio classes. In this class we are going to discuss about some more questions related to cell biology. Now coming to that questions, which of the following is true for nucleolus? Let us see that among all these statements, which statement is true. Let us observe that nucleolus first. The nucleolus is a non-membrane bound structure which is present inside the nucleus. In this nucleolus generally is composed of RNA and proteins, mainly which is involved in the process of rRNA synthesis, ribosomal RNA synthesis. So let us see that options here. Option A, large nucleoli are present in dividing cells. It is not a correct statement. Why? Because the nucleoli is dissipated at the time of division, cell division. So that's why the size of the nucleolus is decreasing. But in interphase cells, the nucleolus is increasing in size. So they given dividing cell. So this statement is wrong. Next, it is a membrane bound structure. So already we know that it is not covered any membrane. It is not a membrane bound structure. So this is statement also wrong. Next, it takes part in a spindle formation. So it is also wrong statement. Why? Because the spindle formation takes place in that cytoskeletal proteins are mainly involved in that process of spindle formation. Next, come to that option D. It is a site for active ribosomal RNA synthesis. This is the right statement for this question. So which of the following is true for this nucleolus? Is it is a site for active ribosomal RNA synthesis. Next, coming to that next question, the Golgi complex participate in, generally the Golgi complex or Golgi apparatus is another membrane bound cell organelles which is present in eukaryotic cells. Generally these Golgi complex or Golgi apparatus are involved in packaging and modifying and transporting of that proteins and lipids or fats into its destinations. In this process, some of the secretory vesicles are also formed inside that Golgi complex. Let us see that options here. Option A, fatty acid breakdown. Generally, the fatty acid breakdown takes place inside the mitochondria and peroxisomes. So here, no role play in that Golgi complex. So it is not a correct statement. Next, formation of secretory vesicles. Generally, at the time of protein modification and packaging, after modification and packaging, the proteins and lipids or fats are packed into a small vesicles that is commonly called as secretory vesicles. So the formation of secretory vesicles are formed from this Golgi complex at the time of transport of the modifying proteins and lipids. So it is the correct statement for this function of this Golgi complex. Now let us see that option C, respiration in bacteria. Generally bacteria is a prokaryotic organism, so that's why the Golgi complex is not involved in this process of respiration. Why? Because the Golgi complex is not present in that bacteria. Next, so it is not a right statement. So here, activation of amino acids. Generally, activation of amino acids takes place in the cytoplasm of the cells only. So in this statement are also not correct regarding Golgi complex. So Golgi complex is involved in the process of formation of secretory vesicles. Now coming to that next question, which of the following event does not occur in rough endoplasmic reticulum? Here endoplasmic reticulum, generally endoplasmic reticulum is another membrane bound structure which is present in eukaryotic cells. Generally rough endoplasmic reticulum is involved in the process of protein synthesis. Next let us see that options here. Protein folding, generally after formation of that protein in the rough endoplasmic reticulum are folded into systematic order, so at the time only the protein must be functional. So the protein folding process mainly occurring endoplasmic reticulum. So this option is right statement. Next option B, protein glycosylation. After formation of that protein in the rough endoplasmic reticulum, some of the carbohydrate moiety are also attached in that newly synthesized protein. So that process are also taking place inside the rough endoplasmic reticulum. So this option B, this statement are also right statement. Next, cleavage of signal peptides. Generally, after formation of complete protein, the signal peptides must be cleaved from that formed protein. So that process are also taking place inside the rough endoplasmic reticulum. So the cleavage of signal peptides are also taking place inside the rough endoplasmic reticulum also. Next, phospholipid synthesis. Generally, rough endoplasmic reticulum mainly involved in the process of protein synthesis only. But in that, phospholipid synthesis takes place in smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So SER play a major role for formation of lipids or fats. So here phospholipid synthesis takes place in SER, smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So this statement is not correct. So here the event does not occur in the rough endoplasmic reticulum is phospholipid synthesis. Where this phospholipid synthesis takes place? The phospholipid synthesis takes place in SER, smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Let's come to that another question. Many ribosomes may associate with a single mRNA to form multiple copies of ribosomes are termed as. Now coming to that options, polysomes is the structures formed from the association of these mRNA with large number of ribosomes. This is commonly called as polysome. Next, polyhedral bodies, the inclusion bodies which is present inside the bacteria, that is commonly called as polyhedral bodies. Next, coming to that plastidome, the plastidome is term used for that a combination of plastids are commonly called as plastidome. A group of plastids commonly called it as plastidomes. Now coming to the nucleosomes. Nucleosomes are the part of, it is a part of chromatin. Generally the nucleosome consists of DNA and histone proteins, commonly called it as nucleosome. Now let us see these options. Polysome. Polysome means the association of ribosomes with the mRNA, that is commonly called as polysome. So this is the correct option for this question. Now polyhedral bodies, it is present in the bacteria, so it is not a correct option for this question. Next, plastidome, it is a group of plastids, so it is not related to this question, so it is also not right option for this. Nucleosome is the part of chromatin which is made up of DNA and histone protein, so that's why it is not a correct option for this question. So like polysome is the term used for that association of these ribosomes with mRNA.